A Templar, I believe.
I can feel another of the elven artifacts.
I know you. They call you the Herald of Andraste for what you did at Haven. But are you? The Maker has not told me.
I am the Herald of Andraste.
And do you claim to hold power over the rifts the Maker has opened in the sky?
I can seal rifts, yes.
Then prove it. Show me that the rifts bend to your will, the will of the Maker. Show me the power you wield.
This cult, what are you doing out here? What is it you think is happening?
The Chantry has fallen, and shown its imperfection in doing so. The Chant of Light was a lie. It was arrogance to think that mortal lips could frame the Maker's will. And so we wait in silence. The Maker has opened the sky. Soon he will call his chosen back to the Golden City.
Until later.
Until the Maker brings you back to us.
I suppose it only natural that some would turn to worshipping the Breach, if only in hopes of appeasing it.
Look, there are Inquisition soldiers even here. I told you we would be safe.
I'm not certain, my lady. We could still return to your family's estate.
No. There is nothing for me back there.
Bring you here.
Thank you.
greet you. My name is Hindle.
Hindle, your mother can't breathe. Your father sent me here for potion.
What? She was fine. She hasn't had the breathing trouble in... All right, I can help. Here, I have some already made. Go, take it to her now.
Working. It should be harder for tears to form here.
No trouble here.
Excuse me. While you were coming up, did you meet a young noblewoman with blonde hair and pale green eyes? Lady Velena should be here. We need to be together when the Maker comes.
I found a woman's body down the hill with a letter on it.
This letter? Velena is dead. But we were meant to be together. The Maker would not keep us apart. What am I supposed to do now?
The Inquisition needs men who believe as strongly as you do. Come and help us restore order.
If waiting here in the hills leaves innocents to die, then I will bring the Maker's word by the sword. My men and I will lend our strength to the Inquisition. Thank you. Thank you again. Lady Velena would have loved this place.
chant of light, for our lips are imperfect.
No trouble here.
Travel safely.
Maker's tears. I was a fool to have doubted you. How may we serve you, Herald of Ondraste?
Have the believers spread word of the Inquisition?
As you say, Herald of Ondraste. Some few will remain here. The rest will go forth to do your will. When the Maker calls you to your great purpose, remember that we served you. The faithful move to follow your divine will. It shall be as you say.
So, who do you think is the toughest? Josephine, Liliana, or Cassandra?
I'm right here, you know.
That doesn't rule you out, Seeker.
Cullen's not up for consideration?
Curly? They just keep him around to look pretty.
We could make camp here.
Hopefully the Inquisition can find some way to help these people.
Right. That's why.
It's good to have commerce restored. I've many goods here if you wish to trade.
Fine day to you.
Do you have the potion?
Here you go. The potion and instructions on how to make it.
Silas, bless you. Or the Maker. Or whoever. It doesn't matter. Just thank you. I'll give it to her right away. If ever I can help the Inquisition, you have my word. Thank you. And blessings upon the Inquisition.
Maker, I hope it's not me.
Yes, sir.
This will help.
It more than helps. With this, I can fill these hungry bellies, give these folks some hope. I didn't think much of the Inquisition, but no one else is helping like you lot. Maybe I was wrong. I pass round what you found. No one will go hungry.
I have heard stories about you, Herald of Andraste. I am Enchanter Elendra. I hope you find a way to end this foolish war.
If you're a mage, why aren't you with the rebel mages?
I was an enchanter in the College of Equitarians. We wanted tolerance, not war. By rights, I am sworn to join the rebels. But I had friends among the Templars. I will not fight them. I know my own strength. I have no fear of demons. I will keep to myself and harm none.
I believe this is your phylactery. I found it on the body of a dead Templar named Matrin.
Ah. I suspected he died when he did not join me or send word. Maker curse the fools who started this war. And the fools who now fight it. Thank you. Matrin was important to me. Here, for your trouble.
I'd like to know more about you and Matrin.
Ah, Templars and mages. Natural enemies, they always say. As though you can keep healthy men and women close to each other for years without anyone getting ideas. We were friends for many years and lovers for many more. And now he is gone because of this war.
You haven't joined the rebels or the refugees. Are you on your own?
Yes. It is safer that way. For everyone. At first, I used my healing skills to help the refugees. But when the Templars saw me, they attacked. Innocent people died in that battle. I will endanger no more.
The Inquisition could use the skills of a powerful mage.
If I wished to kill others, I would have joined the rebels. How is the Inquisition any better?
I came from the Circle myself. I know something of the conflict, and I didn't join the rebels either.
True enough. If the Inquisition believes I can help, then I will do what I can. My skills are yours. Just give me a moment to gather my things.
Did you really think the Conclave had a chance of making peace, Seeker?
You do not?
What was the Divine's plan? Bring everyone together and hope really hard they would all get along?
Most Holy did not confide her plan to me. Perhaps she thought they were tired of death and conflict.
Now, when has that ever been true? For Templars or mages?
I will not mock a dead woman, Varric. She did what she could, and that is more than most.
Is impressive, even as a ruin. I wonder what dreams it might hold. this would make a good place to camp.
Nothing to report, sir. Dispatch for you.
What is it?
This may be worthwhile. Word for you.
What is it?
This may be worthwhile. Place the skull out here, and for what purpose? Look, that's the King's Road down there.
The skull illuminates certain objects in the distance. I am not familiar with such magic.
Of course, it had to be a skull that lights up creepy shit. Want me to handle that?
Say what it is, but there must be a reason the skull illuminates the object.
Thank you.
By the end of Hardin Hightown, almost every character is revealed as a spy or a traitor.
Wait, you read my book?
It was in the Inquisition Library. Everyone but Donnan turned out to be in disguise. Is that common?
Are we still talking about books, or are you asking if everyone I know is a secret agent?
Are there many tricksters in Dwarven literature?
A handful, but they're the exception. Mostly they're just honoring the ancestors. It's very dull stuff. Human literature. Now there's where you'll find the tricky, clever, really deceitful types.
Curious.
Not really. Dwarves write how they want things to be. Humans write to figure out how things are.
Templars have secured a position ahead.
Refugees should have a safer time on the King's Road now.
No normal wolf would fight with such determination.
The breach may have driven them mad, or perhaps a demon took command of the pack.
Thank you.
There are defenses prepared ahead. Prepare yourself. Could make camp here.
Thank you.
We should push ahead. I doubt that was the last of them.
We've been searching the region for resources. Commander's orders. No small task given recent troubles, but I've some supplies here you may find useful. sense elven magic somewhere nearby.
This must be Master Dennett.
Speak to the Master if you have business here.
Shouldn't we travel to Valrayo now, Seeker? Breach isn't going to close itself.
Indeed.
The sooner we obtain help for the breach, the better.
Speak to the Master if you have business here.
So you're the Inquisition, eh? Here you're trying to bring order back. It's high time someone did. Never thought it'd be a mage, though. Redcliffe's had enough trouble with magic already. Name's Dennett. I served Arleman for 30 years as horsemaster. I hear your Inquisition is looking for mounts.
It is. Can you help us?
Not at the moment. I can't just send 100 of the finest horses in Ferelden down the road like you send a letter. Every bandit between here and Haven would be on them like flies on crap. You'll have mounts once I know they won't end up as a cold winter's breakfast.
If you have a problem with me personally, I'd like to know about it.
What? Because of what I said about mages? All the trouble magic's causing around here might well take a mage to fix it. That's all I meant. My wife Elena manages the farms, and Bron's in charge of my guards. They'll tell you what they need. Until then, you deserve something better than whatever knock-kneed plowneck they gave you. The chestnut over there is a purebred Ferelden Forder. Take care of him, and he'll take care of you, Inquisition.
Inquisition.
I heard what my man said. If you want our horses, then we need our farmers back safe in their fields. Since the breach appeared, the wolves have gone mad. They come after our men like beasts with the water sickness. You deal with the wolves, and our farmers will be safe again.
How are these wolves acting differently from normal?
Normal wolves go after livestock, but come at them with a torch and a blade and they run. These beasts, though, it's like darkspawn during the Blight, or when the dead rose to attack us. They're possessed, or something like it. I've lost too many men to the beasts. I won't endanger more.
Farewell.
Good day to you.
The master doesn't want me to fight well out there. If those refugees are going to defend themselves, they'll need real defenses. I've got a few ideas.
You said you had a way to help the refugees.
I do. There are too many hills in these parts, good places for raiders and bandits to gather. I've marked good spots on the map. You set up watchtowers there, I'll talk to the master and get your people weapons.
Farewell.